Hi and welcome. I've been developing projects in Unity for a couple of years at this point, and I wouldn't have come as far as I have without the amazing assets from other developers. In this video, I want to show you some of my absolute go-to packs and tools. To not repeat myself too much after having done videos like this twice before, I haven't added the assets I covered extensively before. So if you missed my asset roundups from last year and the year before, I still use most of those. Go and check them out if you'd like some solid recommendations. This time though, I'm highlighting the editor tools, UI assets, and both 2D and 3D assets that I keep coming back to across multiple projects. Big thank you to Unity for sponsoring this video, letting me pick exactly what I want to cover and how. When this video goes up, there's a yearly summer sale going on with hundreds of assets on sale for at least 50% off. But chances are high you will find these picks in sales across the year and in the future too. You can find links to all of them in the video's description. Let's start with the editor. I use and love every single asset published by Cubato Lab. Each brings a ton of quality of life improvements, and they are probably the ones I'm being asked about the most across my tutorials comment section. V-Hierarchy 2 in particular is an absolute time saver and incredibly easy to work with. It lets you zebra stripe the hierarchy, adds toggles to enable or disable game objects, lets you assign colors and icons to entries and switch scenes by clicking on the scene name. If you only get one from their lineup of editor tools, make it this one. VFolders works very similarly to VHierarchy, just with a focus on your project window. Color coding in general has helped me keep track of things in my projects and scenes for years at this point. I recommend to find one coloring scheme for certain specific elements to stick to over multiple projects. It will speed up your time even more. For me, that's typically a greenish blue for every canvas element and red for every kind of manager. VInspector 2 is amazing for adding bookmarks to the elements you need the most often, but also marking components to keep any changes made to them during play mode. It also lets you copy and paste multiple components across objects at once. VTabs lets you create tabs for basically everything, which is useful for creating shortcuts to folders or specific elements in your project structure. Looking at you, TextMesh Pro style sheets. When I wrote this list of recommendations, I hesitated to add it at first, since I wasn't connecting the name with anything I do in the inspector. That is, until I rewatched their feature video and went, oh wait, this was an assets doing all along? I checked it in a new empty project and yeah, one of my most liked features for the inspector actually comes from this asset. This feels incredibly native to use and is a great time saver. A short but invaluable one is also the aptly named full screen editor. Have a guess at what it does. It's again adding something I'm baffled is not baseline to Unity. Press F10 to full screen the play mode, F9 to do the same for the scene view. I've been using this one since May 2021 in every single project from rough prototype to fleshed out system, and haven't once run into any issues with compatibility, stray errors, or whatever else. Of course, I need to throw Odin Inspector in here as well. I was trying to keep this video as clear of duplicates to other videos as possible, but Odin is one of those assets that fit perfectly into projects of all sizes, and I hear way too often that people let it collect dust in their asset pile. For the simplest users, it lets you throw attributes like button onto methods, so you get an easily accessible button to that directly on your component. Attributes like enum toggle buttons can be added to values and turns a dropdown to separate buttons, which might only remove one click in your workflow, but when you are working with a whole lot of similar objects, like items in an RPG, you'll come to appreciate having to click one time less per object. Make sure to read the documentation about the offered attributes. It comes with lots of examples and great use cases. An example for this in my own projects is that I'm currently developing a pixel art app and have a central component that lets me quickly access different tools and settings. By utilizing the button attribute, I can quickly switch functionality, and by adding a small icon to the button, I have a handy list to keep track of which tool has been implemented in the UI already and which ones I still have to tackle. For simple, rather one-off use cases like this, to whole editor tools and windows like the level editor I built, video is linked up there, Odin is easily the easiest asset to recommend for me. I've been using it since about 2020 in every project. The last entry for this part is Smart Library. Especially if you are working with a lot of assets to sort and store, this one will make your life so much easier. You can create folders in here, name them however it serves you the best, then drag and drop elements into them for easy access. The key is that elements are not being moved in your project, they stay at their original locations. But this way, you can categorize them much easier. If you are working with Synty or similarly large asset packs, make sure to get this and make your life easier. Onwards to everything UI. If you find yourself enjoying a simple, clean style for your UI, modern procedural UI kit is for you. It might sound like one of the many UI packages you can find on the store, but this one is more of a toolbox to easily create basic shapes to use in your UI. I use it for almost all UI elements in Architecton, as well as my pixel art application, and you might have spotted it in the context menu during my tutorials as well. MP Image is somewhat of a replacement to the standard UI image component, but lets you pick what shape you need and how it should be customized with strokes, outlines, corners, and more. It's being recognized as a valid image target for all UI elements too, so you won't have to create any workarounds, which is great. A bit more niche is True Shadow, which adds very nice shadows to UI elements. There really isn't anything more to say about this, it's just very good at its intended use case and easy to work with. As much as I enjoy working with UI, creating settings menus fills me with utter dread. For one, because there is just so much stuff to keep in mind. So many settings, so many, but wouldn't it be neat, elements that make my inner perfectionist freeze up. I only found the settings options menu creator complete asset, what a name, earlier this year, but it took massive amounts of worry from my shoulders. It lets you create settings menus with hundreds of settings to choose from and comes with presets for each element. Those can be customized, of course, and on top, it has a really nice tutorial and overview video that walks you through how to set it up and work with it. Citrion, I hope I get that name right, built an amazing time saver with this asset, and it's easy to see he poured a lot of time, effort, and skill into this. I already covered the dialog system in a previous spotlight video, and while I still think it's an amazing asset, I was looking for a way to handle something like scripted interactive scenes for my architecture game. And while dialog system would probably 100% fit the use case, I somehow gravitated to giving Nani Novel a try instead. It's an asset specializing in creating visual novels with all the features you would need to create those, and wow, are there a lot of features. So far I really enjoyed it and will use it again to create cutscenes like this. Onwards to graphics. Shapes is amazing. It is also rather niche and doesn't work on screen space UIs, which limits it a little bit for my typical projects. But I'm always happy when I come across an idea or project I can use it in. In my pixel art app, I struggled with trying to find a way to display selection outlines, and Freya's asset fit the task perfectly. And just in case you have this, worked with it before and wonder, wait, a dotted polyline? How did she get that witchcraft? It's not. It's just four lines in a row forming a closed shape. But sure looks great, doesn't it? Generally, all of Chronect's assets are great. Beautify 3 is one in their lineup and a replacement for the built-in post-processing effects. I always struggled a bit with the default Unity-made ones, be it their structure, presentation, or ease of use, but I have run into none of these issues with Beautify. It also brings a lot more effects too, like cinematic bars or blinking, which might be a bit more niche, but I appreciate them for being there. Somehow this asset made post-processing click for me. It's easy to set up and fun to experiment with. Can't mention 3D assets without mentioning Synty. I would love to spotlight other packs as well, have tried numerous ones, but when it comes down to quality, extensibility, and amounts of things and textures in a pack, it's very hard to beat Synty, with just one kind of exception I'll come to in a moment. I've been using their packs in all my 3D projects, most extensively in Down the Mountain and Traxanity. Did I mention you can play those two games right now? You can find them on itch. And truth be told, when I was just starting out with Synty, I struggled quite a bit. The modular way their assets are built didn't mesh well with the way I was used to working with just yet. Which is normal, I guess, since I had been exclusively working in 2D and with my own assets before. So it took a while to warm up to working the Synty way. I learned a lot about how to navigate their structures, example scenes, folders, and alternative textures while creating first Down the Mountain and then Traxanity. By now, I feel right at home. And again, you might want to get Smart Library when working with huge assets packs like theirs. I also think that if you'd like to create assets for your own game, but are most comfortable with a low poly style, Cinti packs are easy enough to extend. For my racing game, for example, I added tilted curves and loop-de-loops, and even though I would hardly call myself a 3D artist, the assets work well enough in the context of the projects. For Down the Mountain, I added a lift. All three elements are key elements for the games, and I'm quite proud how they turned out, simple as they are. The Cinti library gets constantly updated with new entries and packs. For example, here I am updating Traxanity, which primarily uses the Polygon Street Racer set, with a couple of new assets from the Polygon City and Polygon Sci-Fi series. While you can see that more recent packs tend to have a few more details than older packs, they can still be mixed together very well, with one exception. Make sure to get at least one of their biomes packs. The trees you can find in the packs with narrow themes are typically serviceable enough, I guess, but feel a bit too low poly for me, and from time to time you'll find four trees and three different styles. The Enchanted Forest one is a great pick, with good variety if you need massive trees or oak-like ones, while the Alpine Mountain pack has straight up some of my most favorite vegetation, period. Both come with a lot of alternative textures too, so make sure to give those a try. That being said, here's a shout out to PolyPerfect's Low Poly Ultimate pack. For one, this pack is packed to the brim with all kinds of scenery objects, all the way down to smaller items to clutter a scene with. And it is constantly being updated. While not as thematically dense as Cinti packs, this one is great to get started, test new things, or just add even more things to scenes you build with other low poly style asset packs. For example, it also works well with Kai Kit packs. And lastly, for effects, make sure to give anything by SignVFX a look. Their effects look incredible up close, as well as at a distance. They are easy enough to customize, and every single one has made me go, wow! Once again, thank you to Unity for sponsoring this video. Which assets will you be picking up? Which are your favorites? Any I missed out on? And make sure to check out the other videos. Have a great week!